Breaking news out of North Carolina, your blood is about to boil. In August, protesters were charged with destroying a Confederate statue that had stood in the downtown Durham, North Carolina since 1924. The statue was torn down during a rally against racism following the violence in Charlottesville, Virginia. A total of 13 people were arrested in conjunction with the events that led to the monument being torn down. Now it seems charges against at least three of those people have been dropped. Aaron Alexander Caldwell, Miles Spingner, and Taylor Cook. Defense attorney Scott Holmes made the announcement to the media that the charges would be dropped, probably an Obama appointee judge. Despite the fact that the probable cause exists, Holmes claims that there was not enough evidence in his estimation to prove guilt beyond a reasonable doubt. He claims that the three people whose charges were dismissed were absolutely innocent and does not believe there was even probable cause for their arrest, despite the fact that there is a video of the events taking place. What did I say? An Obama-appointed judge. This move marks the first by prosecutors in the case against the 13 charged back on August 15th in the destruction of the 90-year-old historic statue. District Attorney Roger Eccles issued a warning that the dismissal of the charges against these individuals should not be seen as any sort of indication of what is to come regarding the remaining 10 cases. Cases continue to be reviewed until they are disposed. No one should take our dismissals of those three as an indication of what will or will not won't happen in the others. Of those remaining 10 cases, seven of them are still charged with a variety of misdemeanors and felonies as it relates to the toppling of the historical statue. They are expected to appear in Durham County District Court on Tuesday to answer the charges against them. Their current charges include felony inciting a riot to cause property damage in excess of $1,500 and misdemeanor damage to real property. Let's take just a quick listen. They have video proof of all of this, yet no charges. There has been a debate among some cities and county elected officials about the statue's value and whether those involved in the toppling should be charged with a felony. Under normal circumstances, felony cases could go before a grand jury within 120 days of the accused's first court appearance. If the grand jury in turn issues a felony indictment, then the case would be bound over from District Court of Superior Court. This would allow for an additional 30 days approximately to allow the case to progress forward. At this point, some officials are considering whether to pursue the felony charges or if some sort of plea deal will be offered from the district attorney's office. Commissioners estimated the Confederate soldier statue on top of the pedestal to be worth $23,789 and the replacement cost to be $28,000. The group responsible for the destruction of the historical statue is known as Defend Durham, a radical communist group associated with the Marxist World Workers' Party. The group issued a statement with regard to the dismissal of the charges, stating this was a small step forward in the fight against white supremacy. Are they idiots or what? I thought I saw a lot of white people there. The group actively advocates for releasing all prisoners, even violent felons, as well as doing away with all police officers. You're kidding me. I see mostly white people here. Oh, unbelievable. You gotta be kidding. Look, white supremacy, they're mostly white. Okay, we got a little bit of a mix, but it's basically white. You know, you gotta be a real kind of stupid to go against your own race. I mean, what are you calling for? Really, what are you calling for? Unbelievable. Let me know what you guys think in the comments below. And again, thank you so much for watching.